Time for a bit of bookie. Cary Grant has been delving into the story behind one of the most danceable hits of the mid-80s.
Yeah, it's a track that had clubbers spinning round like a record, baby.
Right round.
Round, round. Yes. Here we go.
The 1980s saw clubbers in the UK dancing to a brand new sound, Hi-NRG.
Spelt N-R-G. Main thing was, it really made you want to dance.
And a dance craze always creates a number one hit. This one launched a track called You Spin Me Round. It brought together a production team that would dominate the world of pop music, Messrs Stock, Aitken and Waterman, and the talents of a band called Dead or Alive.
I wanted to make a glittery disco record, and I wanted to work with Stock, Aitken and Waterman.
I'd seen him on Top of the Pops. He caught my eye immediately.
Pete Waterman was already well established in the music industry, but he and his new production team were eager to find fresh talent. It arrived in the form of Pete Burns, a young man with plenty of promise.
I just knew the first time you played me the demo that it was there was something magic about it. I just saw that this was our first number one. I mean, you've got to remember, we've been fighting to make a living, fighting to get a reputation, and there you walked in with a piece of gold and said to me, would I shine it? Of course I was going to shine it.
Shine it with knobs on.
Sitting down together for the first time in almost 20 years, the two Petes have no trouble remembering the track that brought them both to the public eye.
Because I couldn't play an instrument, I used to listen to the break sections and other sections of other people's records and sing songs over them. And one day I came across this song by an artist called Luther Vandross, who was amazing. And it was, I wanted your love, baby, your love, baby, your love. And I started going, you spin me right round, round like a record, right round, baby, round, round. I went to the band and sung it, and they hadn't heard the Luther Vandross one, so they came up with other notes, and then I had Spin Me.
The original demo has never been heard in public before, until now. It's been unearthed from the vaults, especially for the One Show. The band felt this lacked the high-energy sound they danced to in the clubs, a sound that was Stock, Aitken and Waterman's trademark studio production. And it went from this to this.
It was the sound of the underground. It was a sound that was fundamentally only accessible in gay clubs. And he'd taken it out of gay clubs and put it onto mainstream radio, which was a triumph. He had the magic touch.
Pete Waterman's vision for this track saw the blending together of three very different genres: the rockier edge of Dead or Alive, Waterman's own dance background, and a great pop track.
If you're able, could you define the sound of this track?
Techno disco. Without a question, that's what it was. It was new technology playing Motown. That's all it was. Taking out the musicians and bringing in technology for the first time. And Pete literally just added a veneer to that that you couldn't purchase.
But this process meant that Pete's band often felt sidelined and tempers frayed. Pete Waterman kicked everyone out of the studio except the sound engineer and finished the track himself.
The thing that everybody picks up on is the little thing that goes... Total mistake. We were so tired. So we left it in and he went palmy. And just went palmy, he was like a kid. You know, you could see he loved every minute. He was so excited.
Mistakes and all, the track became Stock, Aitken & Waterman's first number one. They went on to produce more than 100 top 40 hits with the likes of Kylie, Jason Donovan and Bananarama.
One thing that I could make a living at was spotting what people liked and not just the obvious. And I think that with Spin Me Round, it had been almost like here was 20 years of my life waiting to happen. It ticked every box. I got goosebumps.
Ka-ching. But I'm so lucky to have it. I realise that now as the knees are getting stiff and the teeth are falling out, you know what I mean? And I'm glad I did something that's gone down in history.
Just remarkable. I'm sure you'll agree that the demo for that piece of music was unearthed especially for the One Show.
Unbelievable.
Yeah.